Evo's ground floor will be two stories high to make room for street-level retail stores. The third floor will hold 25 condo units, which means a lot more wiring for things like speaker cables and floor receptacles.
Yeah, they gave us the wrong information. We're actually beyond L. We go all the way up to...
To manage this extra work, Ron Reeder has come aboard as deck foreman.
I got to make sure that what's on these plants is getting in. I mean, it's very easy to get confused out there, and I've already caught a few things already this morning. So one mistake, and then you lost your run. So you got to be dead on. 5'3" east to center.
Off and nine.
Yep, right here.
Challenge number one is deciphering the plans.
So here's this section here.
This floor alone requires four sets of electrical drawings. To complicate things even more, the drawings get updated weekly with last-minute changes by the architects.
Now that line has changed.
Which line are you talking about? Why is this one here?
Because that's where they told me it was. And then after I started looking at it, I'm like, nope. I asked the other day, and how far is the deck going? They said 3 feet past L. It's actually 3 feet past M.
Another problem is that many of the chalk layout marks they made yesterday got washed off.
This morning, we had some water on the deck, and some of our symbols got smeared away. So it's very hard to, you know, notice them right away. So we got to make sure we get everything in before they start putting rebar on here.
To keep this from happening again, they use a can of spray fixer. Boss Bob Mott arrives to double-check their work.
Your wall's like right here, right on the stud. Okay. Just somewhere over onto the side so we can get them down past the ductwork that goes all through here.
He knows that once everything gets buried in concrete, going back will be a nightmare.
That's good. We come up and walk the deck a couple times before they even set the rebar down. It's not his name on the job, it's my name on the job.
Bob also needs to make sure his crew stays in sync with the ever-changing plans.
They've changed their mind. They don't want us to put anything in the retail area, so we're going to have to run that different, so I pulled the box out. This.
They're both gone?
They're gone. Don't put it in.
All right.
Down below us is retail. I can't run anything
right,
in there.
Right.
So don't put it in. All right, man. Well, then I'm going to leave you alone, let you do your job. All right, man, thanks.